Now we have drawn our house and PV array. Next, let's add some shading objects. In our project sheet, we have a cylindrical water tower and a tree. To add the cylindrical object, click Create, Elementary Shading Object. Then select Portion of a Cylinder. To make the object a complete cylinder, select an aperture angle of 360 degrees. To make it more round, let's use 16 segments. Apply the radius and height from the project sheet. Click Close Object. Click to the top view and move the cylinder roughly to where it exists on the drawing, then type precise coordinates. For the tree shape, create a new elementary object. Find Tree under Building Elements. Play around with different settings here until you find a tree to your liking. Close the object and move it somewhere in front of the house. Now our scene is complete, but it is not facing the right way. In the project drawing, you can see the cardinal direction. Click on the Reference tab. To match the cardinal direction shown here, we have to change the field Geographical to Building to 70 degrees. Note that North is now pointing in the same direction as in the project plan. Click on Geographical to see the scene with absolute cardinal directions. Now we are ready to show a shading animation. On the panel on the right, click on Shadings Animation. PVSYST defaults to December 21st for a shading animation. Click on Play to run the animation. You can see early in the day that the cylinder shades the PV array. Later in the day, the tree and the south wing of the house shade the array. You can change the day of the year to June 21st to see the other extreme in the year. In this case, early in the day, the sun is completely behind the PV array. The sun height is now large enough during the day that the cylinder and the tree do not shade the array. At the very end of the day, the sun goes past the house again. To save the scene, click on File, Export. This saves the scene as a .shd file in your workspace and can be loaded into other projects and variants. If you are creating a complex scene, it is recommended to export your scene periodically. Note that it is not necessary to save your scene for the simulation result. When you close this scene, the drawing is automatically saved within the .vcx file for the current simulation variant. Click Close Scene to return to the Near Shadings dialog. If the PV array in your drawing does not match the PV array in your system definition, you will receive an error here that you can resolve by updating the system definition. However, since we properly set the PV array, the dialog gives us a warning asking us to calculate the shading factor table. This table is what PVSYST will use to calculate the near shadings during the simulation. To compute this table, Make sure you select Linear Shadings in the Use in Simulation frame. No Shading will ignore the scene drawing. The other two options provide a more advanced shading calculation. Next, click on Table. This will automatically calculate the Near Shadings table as shown. The shading factor contains how much of the PV array is shaded based on the sun position in terms of solar height, angle, and azimuth. Click Close. To see the effect of shading on the PV array, click on the Graph button. Here you can see the sun path of your site throughout the year. The various black dotted lines on top of the sun path show you shading loss factors at different parts of the year. Close this graph and click OK. Now save your variant and run the simulation. Open the report. On page 5 of the report, you can now see a drawing of your shading scene as well as the ISO shading diagram. We can compare this report to our previous variant with only the horizon applied. If we scroll to page 2 of the reports, we can see that the near shadings construction has reduced our yearly production by about 130 kilowatt hours. In this tutorial, we finished our shading construction and showed you how this affects the results of your simulation.